In every single one of my videos, you'll find one comment that says, the 16th century text, the Hanuman Chalisa, gives the exact distance between the earth and the sun. This idea is so popular that it was even there in a movie.
युग सहस्र जोजन क्या हुआ
9,60,000 मील
धरती से 16 का फासला और ये सब हनुमान चालीसा जैसी प्राचीन किताब में दर्ज है.
Is this true? If not, how do we actually know the distance between the sun and the earth? How do you measure the distance to some place we can't get to? Sure, if we're outside two points, then it's easier to measure the distance between the points. But if we are on one of those points, then how do we measure the distance between them? Let's find out in this video. The Hanuman Chalisa is a 16th century devotional text written by the poet Tulasidas, containing 40 verses in praise of the Hindu god Hanuman. One of the verses says this:
Jug sahasra jojan par bhanu lilyo tahi madhur phal janu.
Now, if you've read the Ramayana, then you'd be aware that there's a legend where Hanuman, as a child, flew into the sky towards the sun thinking it was a fruit. That's what this verse refers to. These words, Yuga Sahasra Yojana, is what is referred to as the distance to the sun. Yuga means 12,000 years, Sahasra is a Sanskrit word for 1,000, and Yojana is approximated as a distance equal to 8 miles. You multiply these three numbers and you get 9.6 crore or 96 million miles or 154 million kilometers. And by modern methods, we know the distance to the sun to be 151 million kilometers, which is only about 2% off. That is astonishingly close. So how did they know about it? Or did they? Before I go any further in this video, I must say, like I do in all such videos, because I know that there are people watching that are scouring through this entire video with a fine-tooth comb looking for a single reason to get offended. My aim with this video is not to malign any religious sentiment, it is simply to correct a misrepresentation of science that I often see. With that said, we should ask ourselves two questions. Why is a devotional book talking about measuring the distance between the earth and the sun? And how exactly do you measure the distance to something that's in front of you? The first ever scientific measurement of the distance to the sun was done by Giovanni Cassini in 1672. Here's what he did. He waited until the planet Mars was in opposition. This means the planet is on the exact opposite side of the sun. At midday, if you're seeing the sun at the top of the sky, then at midnight, you'll see Mars at the top of the sky. Remember that this was a time in Europe when heliocentrism had finally become popular and Kepler's laws had been published. Kepler's third law gives a mathematical relation between the average distance of a planet from the sun and its time period that it takes to go around the sun. So we have this table of ratio of distances, but we don't know any individual distance. That is where Cassini came in. If he could measure any single one of these distances, then instantly we know all the other distances, including the distance between the earth and the sun. He wanted to measure the distance between earth and Mars. Wait, how'll that help? Let's do some basic algebra. Assume this distance is x and this is y. Cassini was trying to measure y minus x, and from Kepler's third law we know y divided by x. That's two equations and two variables, solve it and we get the distance to the sun. That's the easy part. The hard part is finding this y minus x, the distance to Mars. How did Cassini do it? I want you to do something as you're watching this. Hold your thumb out in front of you. We're gonna try and figure out how far away it is without measuring your arm. First, look at it one eye at a time, like this. What do you see? Your thumb is gonna shift back and forth in your field of view. This angular change in position of whatever you're looking at, in this case your thumb, from two different viewpoints, in this case your two eyes, is called parallax. Now, if you know this angle and this distance, then you can find out this distance, which is how far away your thumb is. How? Simple geometry again. This is a circle and L equals r theta. You know L, it's the distance between your two viewpoints or how far apart your eyes are. You know theta, how? Make sure your background is so far away that it doesn't shift between your two viewpoints. Now use some point on it as a reference and measure the angle between it and your thumb from each viewpoint. So for your right eye, if the thumb is at an angle theta 1 anti-clockwise from your reference, and for your left eye it's clockwise, then you could use some geometry to find out what that angle theta is. Good, we just calculate the distance to your thumb. R is equal to L by theta. This is exactly what Cassini did to calculate the distance to Mars. Cassini used two points far apart on Earth as his two eyes, Paris in France and Cayenne in French Guiana in South America. He used the parallax method for measuring the angular displacement of Mars against the background of faraway stars. The distance between Earth and Mars was figured out like I showed you, and using that, the distance between Earth and the Sun. It came out to be around 138 million kilometers. That's 9% off from the currently measured value. So now we have two values, one from Cassini and one from the Hanuman Chalisa. So how should you look at it? Some of you might say Cassini's value is far less accurate than the value in the Hanuman Chalisa, which is only 2% off. And so Cassini's method was less valuable. I disagree. The advantage of this method goes far beyond the final value that I found. It gave us a logic, a technique for calculating this distance, and that makes it repeatable. Anyone anywhere on Earth can use any two other points and any other planet to and depending on how accurate his or her measurements are, be able to get a more accurate value using the same method. Now let's look at the Hanuman Chalisa. All we get from this verse is a final value. No method of calculating it, which means we're just given a number and we're asked to take it upon faith that it's correct. Even if it were correct, how do we figure that out? We'll have to wait till someone comes along and actually measures and calculates the distance and get a reliable value, and then what? Compare and say we had this value all along? Who's that helping? But the story doesn't end there. I didn't look further into all this until I saw this tweet. Speed of light is mentioned in the Rig Veda. They did some calculations and arrived at this highly accurate value. They've taken the same unit of distance, Yojana, the same one that's there in the Hanuman Chalisa, and they've taken one Yojana equals 9 miles. Wait a second, the Hanuman Chalisa takes one Yojana to be 8 miles. I smell something fishy here. Let's dig a little deeper. The Yojana is a unit that had different values depending on where it was used. Emperor Ashoka had used a value for the Yojana which was 4.3 miles back in the 4th century BC. The Surya Siddhanta from the 4th century CE uses a value equal to 5 miles. The 14th century mathematician Parameshwara uses a value of 8 miles for it. In fact, I could find various uses of the value for Yojana ranging from 4 miles to 9 miles. And it seems like the value chosen was whichever one could give us the final result. Hey, let's wait till modern science discovers the right value to use and save. We had it all along. Genius. It's not only Yojana that I find having such issues. Look at this term, Yuga. It says it's equal to 12,000 years. Well, if you look at the Surya Siddhanta, then you'll see that it's not exactly years. It's 12,000 divine years. And one divine year is equal to 360 years. So actually one Yuga should be 4.32 million years, right? So then why only 12,000? Why not 4.32 million? Probably because it doesn't give you the right answer. And also the unit years was used in your calculation. So where is it in the final answer? It's just conveniently ignored. Just think about it rationally. If this devotional book did mention the distance to the sun very accurately using very inaccurate units, then there are two possibilities. Whoever wrote this had divine supernatural knowledge and an uncanny ability to measure things. Someone tweaked and adjusted and picked and chose the values that will lead to an accurate answer, that too after the real value was known. And people who came across this, who wanted it to be true, without even thinking twice, they took it and they ran with it. And now it's been said so many times that people are starting to believe it. Which of these possibilities do you think is more likely to be true? Another thing that you have to think about is, This is a set of devotional verses. Why would you try to find science in there? To be honest, there's nothing scientific about this value. In fact, it shouldn't even be compared with the scientific measurements of the distance to the sun. But I'm forced to make this video because too many people take this seriously. I'd be more inclined to accept this if it was part of a book on science like the Aryabhatiya. People like Aryabhata were great astronomers who made amazing contributions to the world of astronomy, and their discoveries are being overshadowed by absurd claims like these. If you want to learn more about Aryabhata, I've done a detailed video on him, you can check it out. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.